Hello. I'm having a late lunch. It's just now 2 o'clock in California. Daylight savings time. So standard time is 1 o'clock and local time is 12 minutes before that because we're east of the meridian. I'm having potatoes O'Brien with scrambled eggs, Swiss cheese, and some chicken that I stewed the day before yesterday. Gotta eat it within the next few days. Bread, toasted bread, buttered. It's a Wednesday. I'm in the middle of working on this week's homework. Still holding a 97, but I think I'm not going to be able to get it up to 98. It's pretty warm outside. This house is insulated. And since we're so late in the year, the insulation keeps the heat out till around 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So the air conditioning, which is set for 80, has not been switching on until very late in the day, even though it's almost 100 degrees outside. We're having a massive heat wave. Schools are all getting out early, except for the few that are air conditioned. My stepfather had this house redone about 5 years before he died with new heating and air conditioning. He suffered a lot from his arthritis and keeping the house a little warmer in winter and a little cooler in summer helped him. But not just the air conditioning and heating. He had better insulation put in. I'm still daydreaming going to London, but the beauty of a daydream and of armchair travel, you don't actually have to go anywhere. I can just fly around Google Earth and look at the transit systems. Think about how this bus would take me over here to the tower. And how the Piccadilly transit line would bring me from the airport into the center of London. I even found the room I'd want to rent. It's just one room with a bathroom. And in the corner of the room is a little tiny kitchenette. Kind of like what I had in Paris 3 years ago. But because it's dead in the center of London, it costs £1,200 a month. That's like $1,500. But it's perfect. It's right in the center, halfway between Westminster and the city. Very near to Lincoln's Inn. And just about walking distance to the British Museum. About 10 blocks. The British Museum is north of Holborn. And Lincoln's Inn Fields is south of Holborn and a little bit to the east. I love traveling around in the internet, seeing what's for rent, where the museums are. I could even cook my own little lunch there. Scrambled eggs and cheese, and potatoes. I looked at the prices and the food in the markets. The prices aren't bad at all compared to San Diego. But in the restaurants, much more expensive. So, in this daydream, I would be doing a lot of what I did in Paris 3 years ago. Making my own meals at home from food that I bought in the market. Yeah. And there is a museum there. I mentioned it already. The British Museum. And of course, there literally are hundreds of other museums. Some of them are free, some of them cost money. The National Gallery, Courtauld, or Courtauld, where that magnificent painting by Edouard Manet is. A bar at the Folies Bergère. Then, of course, there's the Tower of London. Talk about something to look at. I could live there for 6 months and still not see everything. And by the time the 6 months were up, things would have changed and there'd be other things to see. So that's the daydream. Going to London. It's pretty easy to just sit at home and daydream. Oh yeah. Being an armchair traveler is a lot easier than actually going there. But there is one plane a day, one airplane a day that flies direct, nonstop, from San Diego to London Heathrow. So, that's the daydream. And now I better go back to doing some of my homework for my translation class. Because I told myself, if I don't get an A in this class, I won't take another one. Bye-bye.